Magandang araw sa mga kapatiran, mga brethren, brothers and sisters in Christ in the Negros Island House of Prayer and all the family of the Houses of Prayer all over the nation that may be accessing to this lesson also. Welcome to this second series of studies about our need to go to the courts of heaven by way of the spiritual squads, which were explained in the first lesson sa series na ito. We are breaking down the intercessory community into smaller units called the prayer squads to do spiritual assignments. And nag-start tayo ng last session, which is the first session, on why do we need to go to the courts of heaven and to have the boldness to really access heavenly information in these times and seasons where we need to be operating supernaturally already. Now, in this second series, we are going to take a look at the Issachar exercises, which is a kind of lesson that we will need to be familiar with when we desire to go to the courts of heaven. So let's come to the Lord in prayer. Yahuwah, our Heavenly Father, our Eternal God, our King and Lord and Creator, we come to you now in the name of Yahushua HaMashiach, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And we ask for the spirit of understanding, wisdom, and knowledge, and the spirit of prophecy, the spirit of the fear of the Lord, the spirit of counsel and might, and the Spirit of the Lord to help us go through this second lesson on the Issachar exercises. I pray, Father, that you will bless this word into the hearts and minds of our intercessors today as this is being listened to. And we just give you praise and thanks. In Yahushua's name we pray. Amen. The second segment, my dear brothers and sisters, is called the Issachar exercises. The emphasis is on the exercise, although the source of the exercise or the base of the exercise is the Issachar anointing, which we will look at today. And we begin with a recollection of the position of Issachar in the setup of the camp of Israel. The revelation of the camp of Israel is a very highly instructive prophetic object lesson ng spiritual positioning ng body of Christ in these last days. In the setup of the camp in the wilderness, the wisdom of Yahuwah as revealed to Moses showed that the three forward tribes called the leadership tribes, and they will lead the body of Christ, are the tribes of Judah, Zebulun, and Issachar. In your screen, you will see that the forward tribes are the tribes of Zebulun, Judah, and Issachar. They are called the forward group of the East Gate, and they led Israel into battle every time the Ark of the Lord moves. Now, ano yung Issachar anointing? We begin with 1 Chronicles chapter 12, verse 32. Ito po yung dinidesire natin, especially in this times and season na halos hindi na maintindihan ang panahon at ang nangyayari sa mundo by natural understanding. 1 Chronicles 12:32 says that the men of Issachar understood the times and knew what Israel should do. This is the main, the fundamental essence of the Issachar anointing na tingnan natin ng mas malalim in this second session, because we need this kind of skill in going up to the courts of heaven and going up to the divine council by faith. Now, these three tribes, three forward tribes, Judah, Issachar, and Zebulun, ay nagkakasama. Judah is the praise and worship anointing, It's the leadership anointing. It's the boldness anointing. Remember, this is the Davidic tribe. And it is also, very importantly, the sacrifice anointing. Because Judah sacrificed his life as an insurance for his brother Benjamin when Joseph pretended that he was a ruler of Egypt and did not disclose his identity yet. At pinakuha si Benjamin na kapatid niya. And the brothers said, huwag mong gawin yan kasi mabreak yung heart ni Tatay Jacob. And Judah said, sir, ako po, maiwan ako dito sa Egypt kung hindi i-fulfill ng mga kapatid ko ang promise na dalhin dito si Benjamin. You do with me whatever you want to do. So may sacrifice anointing si Judah. The lamb that was slain becomes the lion of the tribe of Judah. This is the Yahusha anointing. Jesus anointing, willingness to die for the sinner. So, huwag lang natin kalimutan yung Judah anointing. Then, the Zebulun anointing is the business anointing, resource generation, mobilization, and administration, which we will explain. But si Issachar is the prophetic and wisdom anointing. And I am proposing very strongly in this session, hindi po tayo mahiya. Hingiin natin yung Issachar anointing. Yung capacity to understand the times and season so that may practical benefit so that Israel knew what to do. Kasi po, karamihan ng visions and dreams, kung lumilitaw lang na visions and dreams, hindi translated into practical application, how will it benefit and edify the body of Christ? Limited yung edificatory value ng prophetic dreams and visions kung hindi masyado ma-equate sa practical reality. Ito yung genius ng Issachar anointing. Not only did Issachar know how to read the times and seasons, but this is translated into practical reality because Israel knew what to do because of the Issachar anointing. Now, why do we need to boldly desire and long for this gift? Reason number one po, the Issachar anointing is essentially a prophetic anointing. And ang prophetic anointing or prophetic gift, sinasabi mismo ng scriptures in 1 Corinthians 14 verses 1 and 5, follow the way of love and eagerly desire spiritual gifts, especially the gift of prophecy. For he who prophesies is greater than the one who speaks in tongues, unless he interprets so that the church may be edified. Makikita natin dito na yung scriptures mismo nag-i-encourage sa mga anak ng Panginoon, i-desire ninyo, hingiin ninyo yung gift of prophesying. And since the Issachar anointing is a brand of prophetic anointing, huwag tayong mahiya. Panginoon, ibigay mo ito yung capacity to understand the times and seasons in a prophetic way. So that is reason number one for boldness in asking for the Issachar anointing. Number two, the Issachar anointing, remember, is a wisdom anointing. Why do we say it's a wisdom anointing? Because when this prophetic gift operates, Israel knew what to do. May practical benefit. Hindi lang lumilitaw sa hangin himpapawid ng prophesying, but pwedeng dalhin sa lupa na may practical component. So bakit pwede natin hingiin? Because James 1:5 says, if any of you lacks wisdom, he should ask God, who gives generously to all without finding fault, liberally without finding fault, and it will be given to him. Excited po ako dito kasi as the spiritual squads that are being formed in the houses of prayer, Inihop, K-Hope, NICE, and all the other allied groups, maghingi nito ng Issachar anointing, excited ako ng prophetic flow that will happen in terms of wisdom and understanding kung ano nangyayari sa mundo at sa Pilipinas ngayon. Third, why do we have to be bold in asking for this? Because the Issachar anointing is a gift of the Holy Spirit. And Luke 11:13 says, if you then being able or being evil, know how to give good gifts unto your children, how much more shall your heavenly Father give the Holy Spirit to them that ask Him? So tatlo itong promises ng scriptures, prophetic gift, gift of wisdom, gift of the Holy Spirit, ask. Kasi ibigay, ibigay, ibigay talaga. So since the Isaacar anointing is prophetic, is wisdom, is Holy Spirit enablement, hingiin natin ito. Huwag tayo mag-fear at mag-feel na inferior tayo sa mga Bible characters because we are just the children of God as they were, as Isaacar was. And that brings us to the fourth reason why we should be bold in asking for this anointing, because there is no partiality with God. Romans 2:11, there is no partiality with God. Acts 10:34, Peter opened his mouth and said, "In truth, I perceive that God shows no partiality." Binigay ang mga gifts and covenants sa Jews. Sabi ni Peter, nakita ko ibigay rin nito ng Panginoon sa mga Gentiles. The Lord, Yahuwah, shows no partiality. So, hindi ang mga Old Testament believers superior to us now. Hindi sila better because we are all the same, children of Yahuwah. So, hingiin natin ito. So, which brings us now to Isaacar. Now, ito, maganda ito talaga. Who was Isaacar? Sino si Isaacar? Si Isaacar was one of the sons of Jacob through his wife, Leah. And if you are familiar with the story in the book of Genesis, Genesis chapter 30, ito si Leah, hindi ito masyadong mahal ni Jacob. Mas mahal ni Jacob si Rachel. And Isaacar was a middle child, fifth son siya ni Jacob by way of Leah, and sinundan ni Zebulun, sixth son. Okay? Please take note, kasama palagi ito si Isaacar at si Zebulun, at i-explain natin bakit ganyan ang wisdom ni Lord. Kung tingnan natin ang birth record and history ni Isaacar, it would seem to show no indication, absolutely no indication, kung anong destiny and calling niya, parang masyadong insignificant in the natural realm, ang kanyang pagkabata. Even his name seems so off from his anointing. Hindi mo makonect. Okay. Remember Genesis chapter 30. Ito yung quick history ng birth ni Isaacar. During wheat harvest, Reuben, the elder brother, went out into the fields and found some mandrake plants, which he brought to his mother Leah. And si Rachel said to Leah, "Please give me some of your son's mandrake." Yung mystery nito ng mandrake, parang sa research, parang invigorating substance ito na nagtutulong sa reproductive system and may help in conceiving or in conception or in reproduction. And hiningi ni Rachel kay Leah. Itong sagot ni Leah kay Rachel. She said to her, "Was it not enough that you took away my husband? Will you take my son's mandrakes too?" So medyo may alitan yung dalawang magkakapatid kasi they were contesting for the affection of Jacob. Sabi ni Rachel, "Very well. He can sleep with you tonight in return for your son's mandrakes." Kasi mas mahal ni Jacob si Rachel. So dun siya nakitira sa bahay ni Rachel. Sabi niya, "Sige, ibalik ko sa iyo si Jacob," because at that time, allowed pa yung having more than one wife. So, ito nangyari. When Jacob came in from the fields that evening, Leah went out to meet him. "You must sleep with me," she said, "for I have hired you with my son's mandrakes." So he slept with her that night. Sabi niya na in a sense, nabili ko, nabayaran ko ang right ko for you to come home to my tent tonight. You sleep with me kasi binayaran ko si Sister Rachel ng mandrakes, kasi after you sleep with me, ikaw naman mag-sleep with her. Grabe ito ng mga kwento-kwento, but it's in the Bible. Now, look at verse 17. God listened to Leah and she became pregnant and bore Jacob a fifth son. Then Leah said, "God has rewarded me for giving my servant to my husband." So she named him Isaacar. So, ibig sabihin ng Isaacar, according to the etymology, either wages or hire, sweldo or compensation. Ang layo naman ito sa prophetic anointing. There's an encouragement here. Now, please follow with me. The name Issachar seemingly does not indicate the future of this man. And there are those who are listening today. Pwede ba ako dyan sa Issachar anointing na yan? I come from a broken home. I come from a family that is troubled. Wala namang special sign and wonder yung aking birth. In fact, napaka-embarrassing ng birth circumstance ko or ordinaryo lang naman yung pagkatao ko, etc., etc. Well, you hold on because this is fantastic. And when Issachar was born, Leah conceived again and bore Jacob a sixth son. And Leah said, God has presented me with a precious gift. And this time my husband will treat me with honor because I have borne him six sons. And so she named him Zebulon. Si Issachar yung pinag-uusapan natin ngayon. Pero hindi mawala si Zebulon dito, as you will quickly see in this presentation. Now, when they became old and matured, there is not much record on what Issachar did. Parang silent naman ang scriptures kung anong pagkatao niya, pagka-teenager niya, when he became a man. Until in Genesis 49, when their father Jacob was about to die, Jacob released a blessing to all his children, and this is what he said about Issachar. Very strangely, in verses 13, 14, and 15, si Issachar is older than Zebulun, but si Zebulun, sixth child, nauna na rilisan ng prophecy bago kay Issachar. Why is that? Well, the scripture just puts it that way. Sabi ni Tatay Jacob, he was about to die. Sabi niya, Zebulun will live by the seashore and become a haven for ships. His border will extend toward Sidon. This is a business anointing, trade and commerce. Kasi yung sea is port and haven for ships, meaning to say trade. Si Zebulun was being set up for business anointing. And then, pinasok si Issachar, verse 14. At again, kung tingnan mo, parang hindi naman ito very exciting, ang Issachar na prophesying ni Tatay Jacob. Issachar is a raw-boned donkey. Terribly. Raw-boned donkey. Napaka-ordinaryo na animal. Hindi naman horse. Lying down among the sheep pens. What is a donkey doing in the sheep pen? Parang out of place ba? Parang hindi, even in the natural realm, bakit si Issachar donkey? Anong ginagawa niya dun sa sheep pens? When he sees how good is his resting place and how pleasant is his land, okay, so one good point, ang ganda ng allocation niya, he will bend his shoulder to the burden and submit to forced labor. Terrible naman ito na mysterious prophesying ni Tatay Jacob. Si Toto Issachar, as we call it in Ilonggo, term of endearment for young boys, si Toto Issachar, donkey. Then naligaw sa sheep pen. And then, ang lupa niya, ang ganda. Pero, he will bend his shoulder to burden and submit to forced labor. Kung i-fast forward mo ito, what happened to Issachar is in prophetic history, parang wala ka halos makukuha sa mga clues dito na sinabi tungkol sa pagka-anak niya. But here, we do have certain clues. He will have a good land allocation. It is a place of rest. Yung rest niyan is shelter of the Most High, as we will expound on this later on. And it is pleasant because it is filled with the presence of God. And this results in prayer burden. He will bend his shoulder to the burden. magyuko siya at voluntarily pasanin niya yung mga burden ng kapatiran niya, yung mga sheep, yung mga nation niya, yung community niya, into forced labor or heavy service, which you will learn later on, is intercession. He is going to be a prayer warrior. He is going to bear prayer burdens. He is going to plead for the rest of his brothers and the rest of his tribes, because this is his calling. Now, what is the point here? Even if your birth or history may appear so insignificant and contain no clue of your potential, or if you cannot understand your early childhood, like Issachar, you can still be mighty in the kingdom of the Lord with his gifts and enablements. And that is why I challenge the intercessors to eagerly desire and ask for the Issachar anointing. I speak now to my brethren in the New Hope community of faith. Huwag po tayo mag-develop ng inferiority complex na hindi tayo in the level of these great giants of the faith, yung ating mga background simply. No, please, just desire the Issachar anointing. Just desire it. And we have faith and trust in the Heavenly Father that He will be gracious to give it. Now, ang Issachar blessing, though capable of standing alone, explain ko muna ito before I end with the fine points of the Issachar blessing. Gusto ko lang i-bring in si Zebulun para hindi mawala sa picture. Bakit sinasama ito si Issachar at si Zebulun? They were fifth and sixth, coming from the same mother, Leah. And when they were given land allocation by Moses, makikita ninyo that they were together side by side. And as you can see on your screen in the map, they were assigned the smallest land allocations. Tingnan nyo yung arrow. The purple one is Zebulun and the red one is Issachar. Two smallest. Look at how physically small is their allotment in terms of land area. And they are also small in tribal numbers. Kakaunti lang sila. So, kakaunti at small. But, wait a minute. Do not underestimate this, because now here is the explosive Issachar anointing paired with Zebulun, because this is a paired anointing. Fast forward, si spiritual tatay Moses na, hindi na si natural tatay Jacob. Moses was about to say goodbye and he blessed all the tribes. Look at this very short prophetic word sa kay Issachar together with Zebulun. Again, nauna si Zebulun sa mention, segunda lang si Issachar, second. Deuteronomy 33:18-19. O Zebulun, he said, rejoice, Zebulun, in your going forth, and Issachar, in your tents. Tingnan yung contrast. Si Zebulun, may flight na naman, may biyahe na naman. Si Toto Issachar, dyan ka lang maiwan. Meron ka bang medical certificate, pass, quarantine pass? Wala nang kailangan. Dito lang po ako, sa bahay, sa tent. But together, look at the words that follow. They, si Zebulun and Issachar, partners, they will call peoples to the mountain. They will offer righteous sacrifices, or in the modern translation, the right kind of sacrifices. Hindi sila magkamali ng offering sa Panginoon. It's possible to offer wrong sacrifices. It's possible to be misaligned even in the matter of ano bang kailangan ni Lord ngayon, ni Yahuwah ngayon, na klase ng sacrifice. Praise ba? Repentance ba? Intercession ba? Pwede mo ma-misread yan. Pero kung magsama si Zebulun at si Issachar, hindi magkamali ang sacrifices. And then look at the explosive result of the joint anointing of Zebulun and Issachar. They will draw out the abundance of the seas and hidden treasures of the sun. Hallelujah! Of all the 12 tribes, ito lang yung dalawa na nasabihan na kung mag-together sila, grabe, they will lead their brothers in the mountain of the Lord to offer the right sacrifices And the result of that is the Lord is going to be pleased. Yahuwah is going to be pleased. And there will be a release of wealth. Wealth. Now listen, my dear brothers and sisters, in the houses of prayer. We are going to need this wealth. And I am not just limiting our discussion to spiritual wealth. Physical, financial wealth. Kailangan po in these last days. I was just in court this morning. Grabe yun. Terrible yung mga kwento doon. Even lawyers are affected. Our clients are affected. There are so many people losing their jobs. There are so many lawyers even not even able to maintain their basic needs because there are no practically court hearings. And everything is, you know, we need not only heavenly blessings, we need the blessings also of the earth for this last day's difficulty and hardship. And this requires the paired anointing of Zebulun and Issachar. So please take note as we break this down. Number one, the partnership of Zebulun and Issachar is a partnership that will bring rejoicing. Yung dalawang word, rejoice Zebulun in your going out and rejoice Issachar in your tents. Rejoice, O Zebulun, in your business wealth operation. And rejoice, Issachar, kahit hindi ka lumalabas to earn money, mag-relax ka lang, Issachar, as you stay in your tent. Kasi kasama mo si Tuto Zebulun, si Kuya Zebulun, magkasama kayo. Si Zebulun ba nagpipray yun? Parang hindi naman yun nagpipray. Hindi naman yan nagsusoking. Palagi yan sa labas. Kaya nga, kinonek sa'yo eh. Ikaw yun ang mag-pray, Issachar. Ikaw yung mag-spend ng time. Kumusta si Manong Zebulun? Mag-depend yan sa'yo. Ano bang sinabi ni Lord sa'yo, Issachar? I-convey mo kay Zebulun. Manong Zebulun, tungo ang na-reveal ni Lord sa aking tent. Mag-careful ka daw sa ganitong transaksyon. Pero ito daw okay. Dalawa sila po mag-rejoice. Magsama si business at si prophetic, may rejoicing talaga. Magsama yung administrative wealth generation and administrative anointing with listening to God anointing, wisdom anointing, huwag silang buwagin. I-support ni Zebulun, si Issachar. Si Issachar, i-support ni si Zebulun. Grabbing rejoicing in the camp of God. Number two, the paired anointing will cause people to offer the right sacrifices. O Zebulun, rejoice in your going forth and Issachar in your tents, for they will call peoples to the mountain and there they will offer righteous sacrifices. Zebulun with his resources and Issachar with his prophetic wisdom and guidance, matulungan yung people of Israel, the nation of Israel, with the offering of righteous or right sacrifices. Merong sa Bible na maling sacrifice. Ang very common na mali. Misaligned. Si Cain. Malungkot ang nangyari doon. Hindi katanggap-tanggap ni Yahuwah yung sacrifice niya. And then in Isaiah 58, yung Israel at the time, in Isaiah 58, ang daming sacrifices, nagalit pa si Lord. Hindi yan ang hinahanap ko. O sino magsabi, anong tama ba na sacrifice? Sa praise and worship, anong tama na line up ng songs? Sa prayer time, anong tama na temple and spirit ng intercession session ngayon? Offering of right sacrifices is something that will be guided by the paired anointing of Zebulun and Issachar. Third, the paired anointing is a wealth-producing anointing. Magpo-produce talaga ito ng hindi lang spiritual anointing or enablement giftings, kung hindi physical. They will draw out the abundance of the seas and the hidden treasures of the sun. Hidden treasures. Hala, hidden treasures. Lalabas si hidden treasure kung magsama si Zebulun at si Issachar. I'm showing you a picture on the screen ng isang volume of gold bars. Retrieved from somewhere and wherever, and they are already retrieved. I have a question posted there in the screen. Can God's children be entrusted with this kind of stupendous wealth? Pwede bang hawakan ito ng mga anak ng Panginoon? Answer, pwede. Kung magsama ang Zebulun and Issachar anointing. Palabasin ito ni Yahuwah para na ma-handle yung resources at hindi ma-waste kasi guided ni Issachar anointing. Kung Zebulun lang, business anointing lang, acumen, hindi ibigay ni Lord, hindi ibigay ni Yahuwah, you're going to waste it. Mahuhulog yan sa greed. But kung super lang na spiritual, wala namang practical wisdom, administrative skill, you can be spiritually minded and earthly lost. So, sasama talaga ito si Zebulun at si Issachar. That's why critical ito na paired anointing in these last days. There are so many prognostications about COVID. Then sabi nila ganito, ganito. Susunod si ganito, ganito, ganito. Hindi ko gusto i-declare. But these are sad and very severe things that they say will follow. We will need both spiritual and earthly resources. Sino mag-produce niyan? The partnership of Zebulun and Issachar. Now, this is how the partnership works. Rejoice, Zebulun, in your going forth. Zebulun, go! Do not be afraid. Well, the economy is contracting 2-3%. The word of the Lord says, Zebulun, go! Downtrend, do not be afraid. Focus on the word that is given to you and the anointing given to you, which is the ability to create wealth. Okay? But, Yahuwah, I am concerned kasi medyo mahirap ang panahon ngayon. Don't worry because your brother Issachar will guide you. As Issachar stays in his tents, and the tribe of Issachar consisted of the teachers, the scholars, the judges, and the prophetic understanding group. They speak to Zebulun. Now this is very interesting. Why is not Issachar paired with Judah? Or Gad, G-A-D, the warrior fierce, si Simeon at si Gad, yung military anointing kay Simeon at kay Gad. Bakit hindi si Issachar pinair ni Lord doon, ni Yahuwah? Bakit si Zebulun? Ito yung samahan ng prophetic at resources. Grabe ito. This is a paired anointing which I really, really pray now. And I pray now in obedience to a prompting of Yahuwah. Father, in Yahushua's name, I release by faith the discovery and the experience of the paired anointing of Zebulun and Issachar in the Philippines today in Yahushua's name. Amen. I'm releasing it. So the Zebulun and Issachar anointing. This is a profitable partnership where Zebulun's wealth creation at yung business niya was to fund the teachings of Issachar and Issachar's revelation and understanding will be information to Zebulun. Now, this is very practical si Yahuwah. Kasi alam nyo, anong income ng tao na palagi nagpipray? This guy is spending his time praying, receiving from Yahuwah. At grabe yung oras, hindi na yan halos makatulog, fasting lang palagi. What will you ask of your Issachar brother na magtrabaho sa field, mag-farm? Oh, pwede rin siguro, but his calling is to be in the tent. So kung si Zebulun may understanding at may compassion at may affection, i-check ko muna ito si Issachar. Si kapatid ganito, ay saka lang anointing ni brother grabe ang mag-pray at saka class A yung mga revelation, talaga nai-encourage ako. Pero tingnan mo rin yung hanap buhay niya, wala na yung halos kinakain sa bahay niya. Kung ikaw si Zebulun, padalhan mo ng support yun ang mga kapatid ng mga Issachar. This is how it works, the Zebulun and the Issachar anointing. So when Issachar teaches high quality content, and Zebulun applies it correctly, they both prosper. Now, there are examples of this partnership. Elijah and the Shunammite woman. And we will connect this with the heavenly court. Remember, our first session is Heavenly Court or Divine Council. And maybe some of you are wondering, bakit lumayo tayo sa topic? Uuwi ito sa Heavenly Court. Just wait. But here is the example of the partnership. Elisha and the Shunammite woman. This is a partnership of business and prophetic anointings. 2 Kings chapter 4, one day Elisha went to Shunem. That's why it's called the Shunammite woman. And a well-to-do or wealthy woman was there who urged him to stay for a meal. And so whenever he came by, he stopped there to eat and she said to her husband, now look at how the Zebulun type of anointing works. I know that this man who comes our way is a holy man of God. Let us provide for him a small room on the roof and put in it a bed and a table, a chair and a lamp for him. Then he can stay there whenever he comes for us. Grabe yung sensitivity. Oh. Hindi na nagpapasabi, kuha ni Shunammite. Propeta ito. Kailangan ito ng quiet na lugar. So, saan na room? Hindi sa baba, hindi sa bungalow. Hindi sa base, sa basement or sa ground. Doon sa roof. Kasi kailangan si Elisha privacy. Naintindihan ni Zebulun si Isaacar. So, ilayo siya sa traffic ng noise. Okay. And then, kahit small lang, kasi hindi naman yan kailangan ng malaki. Something private with the basic necessities which are bed and table, chair and lamp. Kasi hanggang sa gabi, magbabasa pa yan ng Bible. So, grabe yung Zebulun wisdom supporting the Issachar anointing. And you can read in the rest of 2 Kings chapter 4, 5, and 6, ang ganda ng partnership ito na benefits his Shunammite with the ministry of the prophet, and the prophet was blessed with the ministry of the Shunammite woman. Another example is Priscilla and Aquila and Paul the apostle. Aquila and Priscilla were a well-to-do couple. They were tent makers and they supported Paul. Si Paul was in a sense Issachar, prophet, apostle, missionary. And si Aquila and Priscilla had a Zebulun anointing, administrative, skillful entrepreneurs. So, the partnership, grabe ang partnership. The missionary journeys, the Christianization or the preaching of the gospel in Asia and Europe was assisted by this partnership between business and prophetic. So, these are examples of this partnership in the scriptures. Now, we look at the mystery of this tent of meeting. I'm showing you on the screen a tent, good for one. And the scripture says that, rejoice Issachar in your tent. Yung concept ng tent of meeting, which is what we now desire as Negros Island House of Prayer, prayer squads, na i-develop natin ito yung tent of meeting culture in accessing to the court of heaven, as well as all the brethren of the houses of prayer and the intercessory groups. This tent of meeting, yung fundamental essential concept is encapsulated here in Exodus 33 verses 7 to 9. Tingnan nyo ang very interesting elements ng tent of meeting. Now Moses used to take a tent and pitch it. Clue number one, outside the camp, some distance away. Calling it the tent of meeting. Si Moses ang nagtawag ng tent of meeting. Saan ang location? Some distance from the camp. Number two, anyone inquiring of the Lord would go to the tent of meeting outside the camp. As Moses went into the tent, number three, the pillar of cloud would come down and stay at the entrance while Yahuwah spoke with Moses. So, isa-isayin natin ito. First, outside the camp. Ibig sabihin, this is not the same tent as the tabernacle. Si tabernacle is inside the camp, in the center of the camp. with the three chambers, the outer court, the inner court, and the Holy of Holies, the holy place, the Holy of Holies. That is for the assembly to go to when they meet Yahuwah. But iba yung personal na tent ni Moses. Si Moses had a separate tent, private and personal, outside the camp in order to get away from the madding crowd and just listen to Yahuwah. Ito yung training na gusto natin talaga i-imbibe sa lahat na intercessors. The tent of meeting culture, the tent of meeting template, get away from the crowd. Have some distance from the center of human traffic and population. And this is here where Moses sought Yahuwah, both spirit and truth. He would check the Torah, he would look up to Yahuwah, so the true worshiper worships him in spirit and truth, and Moses would do this exercise in the tent of meeting, and therefore he would be ready to minister to the people in the actual real world. Now, si Yeshua, si Jesus, demonstrated this discipline in his own life, yung tent of meeting culture, template, practice. Makikita ito in verses like Mark 1:35. Very early in the morning, while it was still dark, Jesus got up, left the house. Take note of the word, left the house, and went to a solitary place. Nag-eskapo si Panginoon sa human traffic area to have private one-on-one with the Heavenly Father. What was he cultivating, display? The tent of meeting culture. Now, I am not saying na kung may bahay ka, iwanan mo yung bahay mo at doon ka sa 2 blocks away. No. Principle lang po ito. Principle. The principle is privacy, personal. So, if it is within our own house, maybe when everybody is asleep, 10, 11, then maybe we get up, then it becomes our tent of meeting, kahit sa kitchen lang yan, or sa separate room, or sa downstairs where there's nobody there, and we have our own personal time with Yahuwah. Number two, the tent of meeting, ang main function niya is to inquire of the Lord. May I please be allowed to emphasize the word inquire. This is not to tell the Lord, to inform the Lord. This is not even to ask the Lord for benefits. Ang main function ng tent of meeting is inquire. Inquire. Hindi na sabihin, Panginoon, stop mo yung ano, hirap na kami. That is telling the Lord. That is petitioning the Lord. Panginoon, wala na kaming budget. Ganyan. Well, pwede natin gawin yan, but that's not the function of a tent of meeting. The tent of meeting is to inquire. Ibig sabihin, when we do tent of meeting exercise, kung pwede, neutral muna tayo sa ating opinion, sa ating mga conviction, sa ating mga paniniwala. I'll give an example. May maraming very controversial and very potentially divisive issues in the Republic of the Philippines today. Anti-terrorism bill, ABS-CBN non-granting of the franchise, President Duterte. Oh, tanungin mo yung Christians tungkol sa mga opinions nila nito. Delikado, baka mag-spark, mag-explode kasi hindi mo alam. And people are very passionate with their views. Yung mga galit kay President Duterte, galit talaga. Yung mga believe kay President Duterte, believe talaga at magkabanggaan sila. Yung iba, very supportive ng anti-terrorism bill, even Christians. Yung iba, galit talaga sa anti-terrorism bill. Now, when we go to the tent of meeting, we, for a while, forget our stand. We inquire of Yahuwah. Inquire. The function of a tent of meeting is to inquire of Yahuwah. Trust in the Lord with all your heart, with all your mind, with all your soul, and lean not unto thine own understanding. When we go into the Teto meeting, lean not unto thine own understanding. Yahushua said, I say to you, the Son of Man can do nothing of himself unless it is something he sees the Father doing, for whatever the Father does, these things the Son also does in like manner. So kung magpunta tayo sa tent of meeting, huwag natin muna hingiin kay Lord na ganito, ganyan, ganyan. Let's ask first, Father, what are you doing with the ABS-CBN issue? What are you doing with the anti-terrorism bill issue? What are you doing with this new balita na they will amend and revise the Constitution? Father, tell us your mind first. Inquire. Now, this is very hard for people who are very bright and very brilliant with very strong, well-studied opinions and convictions. But if we are truly children and servants of Him who knows everything, we are neutral and we go into the tent of meeting first to inquire of Yahuwah. You know, Yahushua stayed for long hours in the tent of meeting. Look at Luke 6:12. It was at this time that he went off to the mountain to pray. And he spent the whole night in prayer to God. So that is how Yahushua lived while he was on earth. Third, this place is filled with the glory of the presence of Yahuwah. Ang ganda po ng tent of meeting exercises. When we go into the tent of meeting, Exodus 33 says, as Moses went into the tent, the pillar of cloud would come down and stay at the entrance while the Lord spoke with Moses. In my own personal experience po, my sweetest times of intimacy with Yahuwah would be in this tent of meeting experience when we just come empty before Yahuwah, seeking His face and heart and mind in the dead of the night or in the early morning hours when everything and everybody is asleep and there is no movement in the community and it's just between us and our Heavenly Father. The presence of the Lord is so strong in this wonderful, beautiful time. Now, in the scriptures, I want us to remember that there were instances of blunder in the Bible when even some of the best men of Yahuwah forgot to inquire of the Lord. And may mga sablay po nangyari. If you go to Joshua chapter 9, merong isang grupo, the Gibeonites, which were part of the 7 tribes of Canaan, which the Lord was supposed to have told Joshua to get rid of, to clear the land of these tribes. Nakasama dyan yung Gibeonite, belonging to one of the tribes. And yung Gibeonite, nagpanggap, nagpretend that they were strugglers or beggars, and so nag-request kay Joshua, wag nyo naman kaming patayin. And Joshua just took their report for it without checking. And Joshua 9:14 says, so the men of Israel took some of their provisions and did not ask for the counsel of the Lord. They did not ask for the counsel of the Lord. Hindi nag-inquire. So nasablay na break ni Joshua without intention but for failure to inquire of the Lord, na sana i-wipe out talaga ito. So, kasi nakabigay na siya ng word niya na hindi niya patayin and hindi rin allowed na i-break mo yung word mo, so ginawa na lang slaves. But this is one example of sublay when we do not inquire of Yahuwah. Another example of sublay, another example of a blunder which cost a death, happened in the case of David in 1 Chronicles chapter 15. When the ark was already to be returned to Israel after it was taken by the enemy in the time of Saul, pinadala nila yung ark sa karwahe, sa cart, pulled by animals, and they forgot to ask Yahuwah, 1 Chronicles 15:13, because you did not carry it at the first, the Lord our God made an outburst on us, for we did not seek Him according to the ordinance. Kasi according to the ordinance ng Torah, the ark is supposed to be carried by priests with poles on their shoulders. Hindi po ipapull sa cart or sa animals. So, since they did not ask Yahuwah and they did not consult, na matay ang isang tao na nag-touch ng ark to prevent it from falling down when it hit a rock. So, these are examples of sublime for failure to inquire of Yahuwah. Now, I want the intercessors and all of us, as I read this, this is a fearful warning, at mag-pray tayo na hindi tayo magkamali. This sends holy fear down into my own heart as an intercessor praying for this country, na sana hindi tayo mahulog dito sa Zephaniah chapter 1 verses 1 to 6 na warning. Let me read this to you, Zephaniah 1 verses 1 to 6. The word of the Lord which came to Zephaniah, son of Cushi, son of Gedaliah, etc., etc. Verse 2, I will completely remove all things from the face of the earth. So ang opening ito is a stern warning. I will completely remove all things from the face of the earth, declares the Lord. I will remove man and beast. I will remove the birds of the sky and the fish of the sea and the ruins along with the wicked. And I will cut off man from the face of the earth. Grabe na, nakakatakot na mga declaration ng Panginoon ito. And the reasons are given. Verse 4, so I will stretch out my hand against Judah and against all the inhabitants of Jerusalem, and I will cut off the remnant of Baal from this place, and the names of the idolatrous priest along with the priest, and those who bow down on the housetops to the host of heaven, and those who bow down and swear to the Lord and yet swear by Milcom, and those, now ito yung grabe, please, my goodness, classmate ng mga tirahin ni Lord, ni Yahuwah. Verse 6, and those who have turned back from following the Lord, and those who have not sought the Lord or inquired of Him. In Bisaya, agoy, aray in Tagalog. Si verse 6, nasama sa verses 3 to 5. Yung verses 4, 5, maintindihan yun yung mga idolatrous worshipers, yung mga nagbabow down to other gods which are actually demons. They will be removed along with animals and things on the earth. Pero kasama yung mga hindi nag-i-inquire, hindi nagtatanong, hindi yung mga tao, mga anak ng Panginoon, na walang culture of tent of meeting. Hindi na-integrate sa buhay yung kultura at habit at discipline at delight ng pagtanong sa Panginoon. Consult Yahuwah. Those who have turned back from following the Lord and those who have not sought the Lord or inquired of Him. In other words, they trusted in their own wisdom. They will be destroyed along with all these others. And the Issachar anointing is supremely practical. Practical. The men of Issachar understood the times because they stayed in their tents. They inquired of Yahuwah. They sought His face, His favor, His understanding, His wisdom, His knowledge. And the result is supremely practical. Israel knew what to do. They knew what Israel should do. So may practical equivalence ang prophetic release of knowledge and understanding and counsel. So please take note, Issachar understood the times. Understood the times. This was not necessarily prognosticating or predicting, not even quote-unquote prophesying. This is simply understanding the times, the events, the happenings, the reasons of heaven for allowing these things to happen. And from this base of understanding, the men of Issachar knew what to do and told Israel through the kings and to the tribes, they knew what to do because they knew the times. Now, example dito sa Pilipinas, do we understand the purposes of God for COVID? Now, as I'm speaking now, the Philippines is now number one in Asia. I was informed earlier in court this morning, number one na tayo. I don't know if we have overtaken Indonesia in West Pacific at this time. But ano bang pasya ng Panginoon? Do we understand why Yahuwah is allowing this? What is He dealing with? What is the mind of Yahuwah concerning ABS-CBN closure or cessation of franchise? Whatever. We need to understand. It's very tempting to explode with zeal and conviction, with our own opinions and rationalizations. But the critical discipline now is to understand from heaven's point of view, not from the theologian's point of view, not from the scholar's point of view, not from the analyst's point of view, but from heaven's point of view, we need to understand. And then therefore, we will know what to do when we have the understanding of Yahuwah. A specific example of Judges, of Issachar reading the times correctly. I'll give two, then I will veer this to a close. Judges chapter 5. I really like this. The case of Deborah. This is the song of Deborah. On that day, Deborah and Barak, son of Abinoam, sang this song. When the princes in Israel take the lead, when the people willingly offer themselves, praise the Lord. In the days of Shamgar, son of Anath, in the days of Jael, the highways were abandoned. Travelers took to winding paths. Now, listen carefully. Verse 7, this is where Issachar comes in. Villagers in Israel would not fight. At the time, they were harassed by the enemy, Sisera. And they saw the numbers and the fighters of the enemy. The villagers in Israel would not fight. They read the times this way. Superior ang enemy. Alanganin tayo. Wala tayong whatever, etc. They held back until I, Deborah, arose. Until I arose, a mother in Israel. Now, I want you to see the twist in this passage. Why all of a sudden was there a change of the atmosphere? Look at verse 8. God chose new leaders when war came to the city gates. Why is this so? If you research, because there was a belief in a mental culture among the Israelites at the time. Babae naman ito si Deborah. Gusto namin mga strong men. Saan naman yung mga David at mga Samson na mga type of, yung mga muscle men. Ang lakas ng kalaban natin, babae ang ating leader. So, they will not fight. Hindi sila mag-away. Tingnan mong verse 8. God chose new leaders when war came to the city gates, but not a shield or spear was seen among 40,000 in Israel. 40,000, the number mentioned here, was a picture of unwillingness and unpreparedness because they had a reading of the times na hindi naman ito siguro tama na ilid tayo ni Hinday Debbie. Ni Ate Deb. Okay. Now look at verse 9 and 10. My heart is with Israel's princes, with the willing volunteers among the people, praise the Lord. For the princes of Issachar with Deborah, yes, Issachar was with Barak, sent under his command into the valley. Anong nag-change ng sitwasyon? Kasi sa 12 tribes, at the time led by Deborah, hindi gusto yung mga Israelites maglaban. Ganito yung reading nila. Negative. Oh, hindi tayo ready. Mayroong isang tribe dwelling in the tents. Panginoon, ano ba talaga? Ano bang reading ng panahon ngayon? Boom! The Lord spoke to the princess of Issachar. They called the Madam Prime Minister, Madam Chairman. Ate Deb, pwede bang kausapin ko kayo? Bakit? Nangungusap ang Panginoon sa aming tent. Ano yun? Ikaw po ang mag-lead. Panahon mo po ngayon. Eh, yung iba, hindi maniniwala eh. Sabi ni Issachar, hindi yun. Ang panahon ngayon, sa'yo. Ikaw. O si Barak, hindi pa believe. Basahin nyo nalang Judges chapter 5. Barak will not go unless Deborah will go. In fact, medyo nagalit si Deborah kay Barak, Marine Commander, na hindi mag-go into battle kung hindi samahan ni Deborah. Sino nag-change ng opinion? Si Issachar. Tama yung reading ni Issachar ng panahon. This is the time of a woman. This is the time of a mother. This is a time of new leadership, new style, new strategy, new approach. So, basahin nyo na lang the rest of the story. They won a decisive victory because the princess of Issachar read the time correctly. Yan ang ibig ko pong sabihin na need natin, crucial, urgent need sa Pilipinas ngayon. Saan na si Issachar na magsabi sa body of Christ, mga kapatid, ganito po yung reading ng panahon. Kasi po, nag-fast kami, nag-tent of meeting kami kay Yahuwah. Ganito. Ito po yung na-receive namin tungkol sa COVID. Ito po yung na-receive namin tungkol sa ABS-CBN. Ito po yung na-receive namin sa anti-terrorism bill, sa economy, sa whatever, sa next election. Grabe po ito. How will we go into victory without Issachar? And how will Zebulun produce the resources to finance the assignment that the Lord will reveal through Issachar? We need Issachar. Gabi. Okay. Now, second example as I'm about to close this. If you go to 1 Chronicles chapter 12, may umuupo na politiko at hari sa Israel. Malakas pa at the time, si Saul. Pero, may agam-agam na baka may change of regime in administration. Now, some of the tribes, you will see, were hesitant. Hindi sila magsama kay David. Bakit? Hinahunting ni Saul si David, gustong patayin. Now, I'll read to you a sample of the verses of the hesitation of the other tribes. Huh? The hesitation of the other tribes. 1 Chronicles chapter 12, verse 1. These were the men who came to David at Ziklag while he was banished from the presence of Saul, son of Kish. They were among the warriors who helped him in battle. They were armed with bows and were able to shoot arrows or to sling stones right-handed or left-handed. They were relatives of Saul from the tribe of Benjamin. So may faction ng tribe of Benjamin nagsama kay David. Now look at the next verse in verse 8 as I jump to verse 8. Some Gadites, ha? Take note of the word some. Hindi lahat. Ang iba sa mga Gadites defected to David at his stronghold in the wilderness. Verse 23. These were the numbers of the men armed for battle who came to David at Hebron. From Judah. Ito si Judah na nga, leadership tribe. Verse 24. 6,800 armed for battle. 6,800. This is very few compared to the population of Judah at that time, more than 100,000, maybe 200,000 sila. Pero at this time, 6-8 lang nagsama. Kakaunti. Simeon, 7,000. Levi, 4,600. But, to, bantay ha, bantay. From Issachar. Men who understood the times and knew what Israel should do, listen to this, 200 chiefs with all their relatives and family under their command. Then, hold on, next slide. And from Zebulun, remember, kasama si Tuto Issachar at si Tuto Zebulun. Experienced soldiers prepared for battle with every type of weapon to help David with undivided loyalty. Look at the number, 50,000. 50,000. Yung kay Judah, ilan lang yun? 6-8. Kay Simeon, 7-1. Kay Levi, 4-6. Si Issachar, all their relatives, all. Zebulun, 50,000 undivided loyalty. Anong reason? Why all? Why undivided? Because Issachar already read correctly the times. Pababa na si Saul. Wala na yung pag-asa si Saul. Ma-destroy na yan. Dito na tayo kay David. Now is the time to move with David. Now, yung ibang tribes, teka, siguraduhin natin muna. Baka ma-resbakan tayo. Baka ma-educate tayo. Aleluya. Nakaupo pa yan. Malakas pa yan. Sabi ni Issachar, shh. Sabi ni bossing, David, si Toto David, panahon niya ngayon. Oh, lahat na tribo ni Issachar, sama. Zebulun, sama. Yung iba, wait and see. Tama si Issachar. Perfect timing. So, he read the times and knew what Israel should do. Critical po ito. Critical sa timing natin dito. In the year 2020, 2021, kung mamisread natin yung times and seasons, sakit. I gave you cases of blunders earlier in this episode. Not inquiring of the Lord, not reading the times and seasons correctly. We need this now. Daniel had the same anointing. The book of Daniel, Daniel chapter 2, verses 21 to 23. Daniel said, he changes the times and the seasons. He removed kings and setteth up kings. He giveth wisdom unto the wise and knowledge to them that know understanding. He revealeth the deep and secret things. He knoweth what is in the darkness, and the light dwelleth with him. I thank thee and praise thee, O thou God of my fathers, thou hast given me wisdom and might, and hast made known unto me now what we desired of thee, for thou hast made known unto us the king's matter. So this is the same anointing that worked in Daniel, which was also in Issachar. Ano yung original gift ni Daniel? It was not even predictive prophesying, but interpretative prophesying. Interpretative, interpreting dreams, interpreting times and seasons. Daniel 4:18. This is the dream which I, King Nebuchadnezzar, have seen. Now you, Belteshazzar, tell me its interpretation. Inasmuch as none of the wise men of my kingdom is able to make known to me the interpretation. But you are able, you, Daniel, are able to interpret, for a spirit of the holy gods is in you, sabi ng pagan nga king. You are able to interpret. Is the body of Christ able to interpret? Are the houses of prayer able to interpret? Are we interpreting COVID correctly? Are we interpreting politics here correctly? Reading the times and the season? Yan po ang desperate need ng body of Christ ngayon. The ability to interpret times and seasons correctly. Daniel chapter 2 verses 26 to 28. The king asked Daniel, are you able to tell me what I saw in my dream and interpret it? Daniel replied, No wise man, enchanter, magician, or diviner can explain to the king but the mystery he has asked about, But there is a God in heaven who reveals mysteries. And he has shown King Nebuchadnezzar what will happen in days to come. I wish that we have a little bit of the Danielic humility. Danielic humility. No wise man, enchanter, magician, or diviner. We can expand this to mean no political analyst, no economic expert, no public health prognosticator is able to interpret saan ito pupunta ang COVID, saan ito pupunta ang politika, saan ito pupunta ang gobyerno, yung kagul. Kasi po, may experts, may analysts, yung mga iba, ina-analyze yung analysis ng analyst. Then may third group pa na i-analyze yung analysis ng analyst ng first. Grabe. Analysis, paralysis. Grabe ng analyze. Si Daniel, sabi niya, Sir King, hindi po kaya ng tao, ng mga brilliant scholars at mga doctors. Wala po. Ang Diyos lang po sa langit ang kaya mag-reveal nito. At kailangan magpunta pa ako sa kanya. Tanungin ko pa siya. That is what we need this time. That is what we need. Kasi grabe kahit sa Facebook, ang mga pagsasabog ng opinions between one group and another group, and everybody knows what he is talking about. This is it. Nag-insultuhan pa at and sadly even among Christians, nagsisiraan. Kasi lahat expert. Lahat expert. Sabi ni Daniel, Bossing, hindi po ako expert. Servant lang po ako ng Panginoon. Magtanong pa ako. That is the attitude we need now. That is why Daniel chapter 2 verse 48, the king made Daniel a great man and gave him many gifts and made him ruler over the whole province of Babylon and chief of the governors over all the wise men of Babylon. Dahil sa humility niya, nagsabi na hindi ko yan kaya. Eh, kasi tayo, grabe na yung education at may special ganito at saka may grabing degree at may scholarship sa ganito. I am not belittling these things, but I am setting forth what the scripture reveals. This is not po a game of human acumen and brilliance. The times and seasons we are in requires the mind of the God of heaven and earth. Hindi po ito pataas-taas ng IQ ng tao sa lupa. So, distinguish between prophet, seer, and wise men. 1 Chronicles 29:29. Dinidescribe dito, the acts of the King David were recorded in the book of Samuel the seer, Nathan the prophet, God the seer. But there is a wise man and wise men of the kingdom. And meron nga term, the man of God. I will not develop this. I'm just releasing this as I close. The man of God. There is a term, the man of God. 78 times, this term appears in 72 verses. Man of God. This man of God, these men of God are mostly prophets, but they are also respected for their wisdom. I'm showing on the screen the 13 men of God mentioned in the scriptures. But I'll not go over them one by one anymore. Paki-access na lang po sa PowerPoint slide if you want to study them. But these are prophets, yes, but they are also known for their wisdom, the men of God. And there are other Bible heroes who knew the times and seasons. Moses was one of them. In Hebrews 11:24-25, he sided with slaves and forsook mighty Egypt because he read the times correctly. Hebrews 11:24-25. By faith, Moses, when he was come to years, refused to be called the son of Pharaoh's daughter, choosing rather to suffer affliction with the people of God than to enjoy the pleasures of sin for a season. Jeremiah, because he knew the times, may seeming unpatriotic position siya, which led to great suffering on his part. Kasi hindi masabayan ng madlang bayan yung reading niya ng times and seasons revealed to him by God. Jeremiah said to Zedekiah, which is found in chapter 38, verse 17 of the book Jeremiah, "This is what the Lord God Almighty, the God of Israel, says, if you surrender to the officers of the king of Babylon." Kasi at that time, the Babylonian army under Nebuchadnezzar was already surrounding Jerusalem. And there was nationalism in Israel. We will never surrender. And there was religiosity because we have the temple and the ark of the Lord is here. Parang they treated it as a anting-anting. Hindi tayo matatalo. And then, grabe ka popular yung patriotic position. Then here comes one prophet, Tuto Jeremiah. Sabi niya, "Excuse me, Mr. President, matatalo ka sa Babylon. Sabi ng langit, mag-surrender ka. Ha? Walang hiya ka na propeta ka, ha? Wala kang pagmamahal sa bayan." Kasi hindi patriotic yung statement niya. And his unthinkable message, not only did he say that Israel will be defeated by Babylon, ito pa yung grabe. Parang nasobrahan siya sa revelation niya, Jeremiah 29:7. And the Lord says, "Seek the peace of the city where I have caused you to be carried away captives, and pray to the Lord for it, for in its peace you will have peace." Ha? Hindi lang kami talunin ni Babylon, ipagpapray mo pa yung Babylon? Sobra ka naman, Jeremiah. Grabe. This is the quote-unquote danger of going to the court of heaven and receiving revelation. Kasi yung iba, hindi naman nagko-court of heaven, hindi naman nag-tent of meeting, popular opinion, analysis, expert view, patriotism, pure and plain. But without revelation, bangga yung prognostication. So, Jeremiah was beaten, packed, imprisoned for treason. Treason. Basahin nyo lang po sa book of Jeremiah. Wala sa yung panahon. But just read it. He was thrown into a muddy cistern, sunk in the mud, and left for dead because he was a traitor to the temple, traitor to Israel, unpatriotic, collaborator to the enemy. Now, question, why did Jeremiah stick to his seemingly unpatriotic position? Terribly po. When he said that peace and prosperity of the city to which I have carried you, pray for it. Why did he stick to it in spite of all the trouble that he was suffering from? Oh. Reason? Balik tayo sa court of heaven. Akala nyo na wala tayo sa court of heaven. We end this with a return to the topic that we are in for this series. Jeremiah 23 verses 21 to 22. Yahuwah speaking, God speaking, telling these other so-called patriotic prophets. The Lord rebukes them. This is what the Lord said. "I did not send the prophets, yet they ran. I did not speak to them, yet they prophesied. But if they had stood in my counsel," divine counsel, "if they had stood in my counsel, then they would have proclaimed my words to my people. They would have turned them from their evil way and from the evilness of their deeds." But si Jeremiah 23 verse 18, "For who has stood in the counsel of the Lord? Who has perceived and heard His word? Who has marked His word and heard it?" Grabe. Ito palang hindi makapalag si Jeremiah because he stood in the divine counsel. He stood in the heavenly court. Remember all the things he said in the first lesson, and we will develop this in the third segment. we are encouraging everybody to go to the heavenly court. Yan po ang kaibahan ni Jeremiah with the other prophets. Jeremiah had access to the counsel of the Lord. King James Version, C-O-U-N-S-E-L. But majority of the translations, especially the original Hebrew and Aramaic, is counsel. He stood in the divine counsel. We'll talk about that next session. How do we stand before the divine counsel? How are we common, ordinary human beings, believers of Yahuwah? How are we able to access? We'll talk about that next session. But you see, understanding the times and seasons, therefore, required an access to the heavenly perspective and wisdom, seeing things from above. And this is best achieved by standing in the counsel of God. I-desire po talaga natin, I'm now speaking to the spiritual squads, prayer groups of Nihok and Kehok and Nisi and all the allied houses of prayer. I-desire po natin talaga mag-go to the heavenly courts. Remember the first lesson, nothing on earth will happen without a favorable court order from heaven. We need to access the courts of heaven. Now, we are not technical here. We need to say this. We do not, quote-unquote, require our intercessors to have actual, ethereal, mystical experiences of appearing or standing in the courts of heaven or in the divine council. Hindi po require na. Nakita mo si Abraham, nakumusta mo doon si Elijah, hindi naman tayo ganyan. We are not going overboard. We just really desire to simply just go up. Just go up, ascend to the heavenly realms by faith. Go beyond the mere earthly perspective. Go beyond mere earthly opinion, analysis, criticism, evaluation, academic, and even theological. We just need to come empty before the presence of God and just let Him download heaven's perspective of the Father's heart and mind and will. So, the instruction and the challenge is this. We might have to do this individually first, but later on do this as a group. Simple steps. Let's go for cleansing of our hearts. Let's go into praise. Then after that, we inquire with the throne, believing that we are in the court of heaven by faith. And baka nakasulat na yung inquiries natin, basahin natin, or we just say it but guided by our notes. And we need to be precise and be specific. Then after that, give time for the Lord Yahuwah to speak. Let everyone then share. Yung giving time for Yahuwah to speak, give it some minutes of quietness, silence. Then allow people to journal what they are receiving. Then as the leader discerns na okay na, have you received? Then let everyone share. And ask the seers what they see. And check the scriptures. Then collate what has been received. And then come up with a report. We will expound on this more clearly next time. But in this second segment, we are already releasing a little bit of the how. But that is the challenge that we pose now to the brethren. Sample topics for reading of times and seasons. I encourage everyone, i-reading natin yung Philippine COVID situation. I-readingin natin. Let's do an Issachar exercise. Let's ask Yahuwah in the tent of meeting, Panginoon, bakit ito yung rate of infection? Nag-exceed na kami ng 1,000 a day. Bakit ganito ng sitwasyon? Why is Thailand okay na? Why is Vietnam okay? Why are we still parang seemingly not okay? Let's ask Yahuwah for an Issachar operation in our situation. Number two, let's ask Yahuwah for a reading of the Philippine government political situation. Saan ito pupunta ang policy at mga aksyon ng gobyerno. And let's try to be, again, neutral before the presence of Yahuwah. Let's just allow God to speak to us. And the number three, what is the state of the Ecclesia, the body of Christ? Ito lang po yung basic three things na siguro the big picture muna, the macro picture. And let's ask Yahuwah to help us, like Issachar, to understand the times and seasons. And then, hopefully, we will know what to do. The Philippines will know what to do. The body of Christ will know what to do after we understand the times and seasons. So let us do these Issachar exercises. Let's go inside our tents of meeting individually and collectively. Let us read the times and seasons here in this tent of meeting situation. Let Yahuwah reveal Himself to us. Father, we thank You for the second segment of our series of lessons that You are downloading to us. We believe that these things come from You with a sense of urgency, with a sense of urgency that we need to learn fast because we have entered the season of suddenlies and quicklies, and we need to learn how to hear from You, receive from You. Father, we ask for the Issachar anointing. Give us the Issachar anointing. Wisdom, understanding, hearing from You, alignment with Your roadmap, with Your program and agenda for the times and season. More than human intellect and analysis and academic and university training, we want to understand Your ways, Your thoughts, Your heart. And we seek this, Father, for Nihop, for Nisi, for Kehop, for Mihop, for Mahop, for all the houses of prayer, for all the allied networks, especially those who have houses of prayer, those who have prayer groups, and everyone who feels called to this ministry of intercession. Father, have mercy on us. Have mercy on us. We desire these things to understand Your ways and Your thoughts. And so we commit this lesson to You. And we just give You back all the honor, glory, praise, and thanks as You continue to educate and train us for these last days as we prepare the way of Yahuwah, King of Kings and Lord of Lords. In Yahushua's name we pray.